Hello, this is Nitesh, and in this video we are going to make a React portfolio website that you can share with your recruiters and other members. In this portfolio you are going to represent who you are and your name, skills, work experience along with your projects and many more things that come to your list as a one-page design. This is my portfolio and you can design it completely your way. So I have designed the code in such a way that you need to make some minor changes and then you are ready to go. So just make some small changes in the code which I have written and then you can deploy that on the application server. I will show you all the steps how to do that. So you can go about, you can download my resume as well, the education, work, skills, the projects, the clients I've worked with. You can go to contacts. Go on top. Now, in order for you to be able to get this portfolio, you are gonna need to go on GitHub. And you just need to follow a few steps that I will let you know. So this is the link that you need to follow, and I mentioned this link in the description below. And just go to this link, install VS Code, then sign up for a Netlify account and install Node.js, because it is required for your application to run. So I have designed the code using ReactJS. ReactJS is nothing but just open source JavaScript library, and which has been created by Facebook for building user interfaces. And it's a very powerful library that efficiently updates and renders the right component, you can say, in every page and when the data changes. So only that component gets changed again and again. So whenever a page gets refreshed, only a component which has been changed gets updated, not the whole page. So that is the benefit of this ReactJS. That is why we call it as this is very powerful. So just install these three things, install VS Code, sign up for Netlify, and then install Node.js. Then we are good to go. When you install this, just go there, download this, and install it at your system. Then install this Node.js by going to this link. You can select the latest version. Then sign up for Netlify. I will let you know at the last step, because this is we're going to use at last. Okay. When you are done with the installation of VS Code, you just open the VS Code. So I'm launching the VS Code. Initially, this is how your page will look like. Welcome page. Now go to my GitHub link. Just download this zip file, open the concern folder, double click to extract it, open VS Code. Now what you can do, just drag and drop this folder on this window. That's it. Now you can see the files in the sidebar, but is it ready to be deployed? No, there are some dependencies in your project that you need to install, and for that we need to run few basic commands. To run the commands, just open the terminal. So to open the terminal, just go in terminal, new terminal. So my terminal is already open, so just I'm showing you the path how you can open the terminal, because in your case this terminal would not be there. Or you can use the shortcut for Mac OS, it's Command+J at a time, And for Windows operating system, it's Alt+J. You just need to make changes in this JSON file. You can check. This JSON file is in this public folder. Public. Then go to JSON file. You can see my name, occupation, description, bio, contact messages, all the informations are available in this JSON file. So I'm reading the data from this JSON file. Website, the social, the links of the pages, images, the work descriptions, all the companies I mentioned here, the skills, the level for that, everything. Now, for these different sections, home, about, works, testimonials, and contacts, when you go to this one, just close this public folder. You can see in source src folder, go to components, you will see about, contact, header, portfolio, testimonials, which is corresponding to these tabs. For example, what you need to do, just make some small changes. Okay, now what are the things required to run this program? The first step, go to GitHub, copy npm init, run it. So this command can be used to set up a new or existing npm package. Just enter any package name, in your case you will get this author name, so you can put your name. Click enter. Good. Then npm install. This command pulls out all the required node modules. So whatever the dependencies that your project have, it will pull out all those dependencies. So for the time being, just remember that thing, that you need to run npm init, then npm install. Just for the learning purpose, you need to install this also. Just click on this. In the search bar, just type ES7 React. In my case, it is already enabled. That is why I'm getting the option of disable. But you will get an option of enable here. So just enable it. It's because this is the extension that you will need to run the React and the Redux code on your system. So I'm making few changes. Let us say this is the software developer. Save it. Now this person is in California. Will take some time to update. We can go to this. Because see, in this script file, we are reading this name, bio, street, city from the JSON file, this JSON file. Can change the images. As you can see, this was the name of the picture that I have had, nitish.jpg. message available here. So you can just put your image and just change this name by the file name that you have get. Then meanwhile, what we will do, we will create one account on Netlify. Just click here. I do have my account on Netlify, so I will log in directly. You need to sign up for that because you are going to the for the first time on this Netlify account. Once you log in, you will get these tabs. Just go on sites. It's updating, it's taking time, it will take some time. Once it is done, so what we are gonna do, this is the page where we are going to deploy our application. So once this application is built, what we are going to do, we will deploy that application on this Netlify. This provides a platform where we can build our application and then we can directly deploy here and generate an URL link which we can share with others. You can see the application, the packages has been updated here. Now what you can do, run npm start to start your application on the localhost. It will deploy on the application server locally. It will trigger, see, on the localhost 3000 is the by default port for ReactJS. So it will trigger the application on your by default browser at 3000. In your case, it could be different if you are using this application. You can see the changes are getting reflected on our application pages. We had made some changes in the name, and with the email ID and the occupation, you can see the occupation of this person has been changed. Versatile senior, not this one, but see the email ID. So in this way you can change this data from here, and from these folders you can change the data as per your convenience, the data that you need to have on your website. So these are the files where you need to make certain small changes, and from here also we are getting the data from the JSON file only. So just make small changes, play with the code. This is the platform that has already been created for you. Just you need to make some small changes and then check. Whenever you make some small changes, for example, see, I'm again changing the data. Just I will run it parallel. See how powerful this React is. See, it will automatically get updated on the localhost. You can see that. Now what you can do, once you are done with the changes, just go to another terminal, then build this application using npm run build. You can get this command on my GitHub also. So this is the Netlify account, and you can go back. So run this command, the last command that we need to run, this npm run build. Once the application gets built, it will create a build folder. So if you might have noticed, this build folder was not there initially. When you run this command, a build folder gets created. So while deployment, we just drag and drop the build folder on the Netlify. So I'm logging again in my Netlify account. It is still creating an optimized production build. Once the build folder has been created for this particular web application, we are ready to deploy it on the application server. And then you can share the generated link with your friends, recruiters directly. So now you can see the build folder is ready to be deployed. So whenever you make any changes in the application, you just need to run npm run build command all the time. Not npm init, npm install. That is, we use that for the first time only. But whenever you are making any changes in your application before deployment, you need to run this command, npm run build. So always remember to build your application before deployment. Once it was done, you have installed, you had downloaded your application in the download. Now you can see there is a build folder here. What you need to do, once this build folder gets generated, just drag it in this section. It will generate, it will automatically generate one link. You can see this link has been generated. Just click on this. Your application is live now. So you can see just by clicking drag drop the build folder and deploying it on the Netlify, how simple is that? So this link URL link looks something different, but you can customize that as per your wish. Just go here, go to site settings, change site name. I want it to be David Smith for the time, save it. If it's available, you can easily, so if you have customized your URL link for your web application, so you can do that. If it's available, you can customize it as per your wish. So just you need to make some small changes in your file, then build it using npm run build, and then drag and drop on the Netlify. So you can make again the new changes on the same. Just go to your website, go to deploy section, again drag and drop here the new changes that you have performed. So your application is now ready to be used. So just customize the folder and then see how it works. That's it. Thank you.